Hey guys, I'm Dr. Jason Barker with the Natural Athletes Clinic, and today I'm going to talk to you about why endurance athletes are at greater risk for developing leaky gut syndrome. And what is leaky gut syndrome? This is a condition whereby the GI tract starts to absorb things that it shouldn't be absorbing. This is stuff like bacteria or other incompletely digested proteins. Now, the problem with this is that a large amount of our immune system surrounds the gut. And so when the immune system meets these things that should not be outside of the gut layer or the gut wall, bad things start to happen. You're at a greater risk for systemic bacterial infections, and then you're also at greater risk for developing autoimmune diseases, and those are conditions whereby your immune system starts attacking different parts and different areas of your body. Both bad conditions, we don't want to have to ever deal with those things, so I'm going to tell you how to take care of leaky gut in the first place. So why are endurance athletes at risk for developing leaky gut in the first place? Well, there's two simple things that happen, and that's basically when we're out exercising, that blood flow leaves the gut, goes out to the working muscles, and then you couple that with the rise in the core temperature that happens, and this is also worse if you're out on a hot, sunny day. That heat, coupled with that lack or the relative lack of blood flow, can really damage that sensitive gut lining and create that leaky gut condition. So how do we take care of this? So first things first is you've got to get a food sensitivity test. We've got to know which foods may be damaging or putting a burden on your digestive tract in the first place. So we've got a kit you can do at home. You can test 96 foods or you can test 184 foods. And keep in mind, this is a sensitivity test. This is not an allergy test. And sensitivities are more like a smoldering reaction. So you can be eating a food and not really know that you've got a sensitivity because the symptoms don't show up for maybe 24 or 48 hours later. So you need to identify and remove the food sensitivities. That's the first order of business. Second thing is your diet. You've got to be eating a really, really healthy diet all the time. You need to be on an anti-inflammatory diet. So plenty of plants, soluble fiber, nuts, seeds, beans, of course, lean meats, some fish in there. Fish is good for, of course, the omega-3s that are in it are very anti-inflammatory. So you've got to have a very healthy diet to make sure that your gut health is very on point and you stay healthy in that regard. And of course, part of that diet is getting all of the processed stuff out of there. Of course, the sugar, the chemicals, the flavorings, all that junk that's in processed food. And of course, alcohol isn't good for your gut. And of course, the worst thing you can do to your gut is take antibiotics and take NSAIDs or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Now, antibiotics, you may not have a choice all the time, but you need to be very selective if you do wind up taking antibiotics, because of course they kill all the bacteria in your body, including the good stuff in your gut. And then the NSAIDs, those drugs have a very nasty side effect of causing your gut to bleed. And they do this because they inhibit the secretion of that protective mucosal layer that your gut makes to protect itself from the digestive enzymes that it secretes to digest the food. So cut that stuff out of your body as best you can. Now, how do we treat leaky gut once you have it? Well, I've got a handful of suggestions here. So first thing is to use something called glutamine. So glutamine is an amino acid. I talk about this one a lot. It's a primary fuel source for the enterocytes, which are the cells lining your GI tract. So glutamine helps rebuild the lining of your GI tract. Now, athletes, there's some good studies that show that glutamine is depressed in athletes after a hard bout of exercise. So there may be a link between that endurance exercise and lowering glutamine and increasing leaky gut. I don't know if that's true or not yet, but something to consider. Of course, the next thing is probiotics. Okay, probiotics have been very well researched, lots of health benefits throughout the body. We have about 100 trillion bacterial organisms living in our gut. So that's about 10 times the amount of human cells that we're actually made out of. So we're actually more bacteria than human, if you think about it. That always blows my mind when I think about that. But anyway, you've got to take a probiotic. Probiotics have been shown to decrease the incidence and the severity of respiratory infections, other infections throughout your body. They have antioxidant effects. Even that gut-brain connection is being more established in the research. So anyway, everybody should be taking a probiotic, especially if you're an endurance athlete, to help keep that bacterial balance very healthy in the gut and preventing that leaky gut from happening. Next thing you can take is something called gamma oryzanol. Gamma oryzanol is a derivative from rice bran oil. This is it has a very powerful anti-inflammatory effect on the gut lining, so it's great at putting out those fires. And then the next botanical medicines I like to use are okra, slippery elm bark, and marshmallow root. And these three botanicals are classified as demulcents, and demulcents help soothe and restore the gut lining. So those are very important to take. if you are looking at leaky gut or trying to prevent it. And then the last thing that I like to use is deglycyrrhizinated licorice, otherwise known as DGL. And the deglycyrrhizinated part is we just take the glycerin out of the licorice because that's a compound that can raise your blood pressure if you take it for too long. So the DGL is very safe to take for the long term. Again, it helps stimulate the synthesis or the growth of that mucosal lining that we need to protect our gut from itself. And then if you want something more convenient, we have the Mountain Peaks permeable gut formula, which contains all those botanical and natural medicines I just mentioned, plus a few others. So you can take this one, supplement your diet with a probiotic, and take out those food sensitivities, of course, clean up your diet, and you'll be well on your way to doing all you can to protect your gut from developing leaky gut syndrome. So if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. And of course, more importantly, please share this with your endurance buddies so that they do not develop leaky gut syndrome, and hopefully that prevents them from getting something like an autoimmune disease. And of course, please subscribe to our channel. We're always making new videos. So thanks for watching, guys.